Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Ministers will ban sale of puppies and kittens from pet shops and unscrupulous puppy farms following a campaign to introduce a Lucy's Law. The ban on third-party sales of the pets should help to drive up animal welfare standards, Environment Secretary Michael Gove said. It comes after the prominent Lucy's Law campaign to end the scandal of animals being bred in cruel conditions and transported long distances to be sold. The campaign was named after a Cavalier Spaniel who was rescued after being kept in a cage on a puppy farm. Scroll down for video. Lucy, the Cavalier Spaniel who was rescued from a cage in an unlicensed puppy farm. The ban will include pet shops, puppy farms and other commercial dealers, according to the plans put out for consultation. Anyone buying or adopting a pet less than 6 months old will have to deal directly with a breeder or a rescue center under the proposed ban. Many puppies are currently being separated from their mothers too early, so the new law will make it illegal to sell them without their mothers present. The move aims to reduce serious health problems and socialization issues which afflict pets kept in poor conditions by unscrupulous, profit-driven breeders. BBC Scotland investigates Britain's puppy dealers exposed showed boxes full of pups being reared to be sold after living in cramped and squalid conditions shot in a Scottish puppy farm. This picture shows Basset pups crammed into an enclosure. BBC Scotland commissioned the show into the world of puppy farms north of the border. Mr. Gove said, a ban on third-party sales will ensure the nation's much-loved pets get the right start in life. People who have a complete disregard for pet welfare will no longer be able to profit from this miserable trade. A petition supporting Lucy's Law has been signed by nearly 150,000 people and was debated in Parliament in May. Lucy's Law campaign was started by TV vet Mark Abraham from Brighton. Speaking yesterday outside Downing Street flanked by a host of celebrities including Eamon Holmes, he said, for years irresponsible breeders in the UK and abroad, puppy farmers have used third parties to keep themselves well hidden from the public. By banning third-party sellers, Lucy's Law will ensure breeders are accountable, making it the first big step in puppy farm cruelty. The consultation follows a call for evidence on the ban which ran from February to May. Mark Abraham, of the Pup Aid campaign, said, for years irresponsible breeders in the UK and abroad, e.g. puppy farmers, have always used third parties to keep themselves well hidden from the buying public. Lucy's Law will ensure the sellers of puppies are accountable, in a move that combats cruelty. By banning third-party sellers, Lucy's Law will ensure all breeders are accountable, making it the first major step in tackling puppy farm cruelty. David Bowles, Assistant Director of Public Affairs at the RSPCA, said, the RSPCA knows firsthand the misery the puppy trade causes to dogs and families. The only people who profit from this unscrupulous trade are the sellers. We believe it's vital to crack down on this underground trade to provide much-needed protection to dogs and people, and welcome an end to the third-party sales of puppies. Paula Boyden, veterinary director at the Dogs Trust, welcomed the move but said additional steps were needed to safeguard the health of pets. She said, we believe that to be effective, a ban needs to be supported by some key additional measures, such as regulating rehoming organizations. The puppy farm problem extends beyond Britain and into Ireland. This dog was shown in a program called The Truth About Ireland's Puppy Farms. These measures will close off potential loopholes and ensure a ban is the success we all want to see. New laws come into force on October 1 banning licensed sellers from dealing in puppies and kittens less than 8 weeks old. The announcement follows a commitment by the Prime Minister Theresa May in December to crack down on cruel puppy farms. The new plans also aim to clamp down on young animals enduring long journeys after being sold which lead to serious health problems. Government plans are also targeting the breeding of dogs with severe genetic disorders, as well as increasing sentences for animal abusers.